Hello everyone, this is Professor Shweta Sharma from ICFAI Business School. I am associated with ICFAI Business School for the last 8 years. My research areas include blockchain technology, cloud computing, analytics, automated regression testing, and software engineering. I have taught in various academic institutions such as Ideal Institute of Management associated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. I've taught in JK Business School, which was associated with MDU. Then I've taught in Gyan Jyoti, which is associated with Punjab Technical University. And I've also taught in Institute of Management Education, which is associated with UP Technical University. I'm primarily an academician by profession. So my experience is, I have worked with various universities of repute. I've published papers in national and international conferences of Springer and IEEE, primarily in the area of blockchain and cloud computing. Today, I'll take you through a course of Advanced Business Analytics. This is a course which we offer to second year students in semester 3. For further information, I'll just take you through a small presentation. So here you can see that I've given my LinkedIn address and you can browse through my profile further. This is about your course on Advanced Business Analytics. In semester 1, we have a subject of Introduction to Business Analytics. So this subject of Advanced Business Analytics is further on that. So, you know, you would have studied various analytical techniques in the subject of quants, right? So quantitative analytics is a subject which we offer in semester 1. And we offer a subject of Introduction to Business Analytics in semester 2. So this subject is an extension of that. We will be studying primarily how to implement exploratory data analysis, modeling techniques, and other models with the use of R programming and Advanced Excel. So here we will be working on certain live projects and some live data, which will tell you how to extract the data from various portals such as Facebook, Twitter, you know, whatever is trending. So let's say, for example, some campaign has to be run for a company, and for running that campaign you need to do the customer data analysis. So how can you get hold of that secondary data? How can you extract that data? How can you improvise on that data? And how can you apply all these tools to further extend? Let's talk about the teaching pedagogy now. So when I say teaching pedagogy, means, you know, in the current circumstances, we will be having our sessions as a combination of synchronous and asynchronous. So when I say synchronous, so synchronous primarily means there will be online video sessions. So online video calls will be there and all the students will be present in the online classes, and they will be supported by various activities which will be conducted on our LMS, that is QuickForce. So you'll have your peer evaluations, your peer communications across, you know, we have different ways of communicating online. You might have heard of tools, various video conferencing tools like Zoom is there, Google Meeting is there, then Microsoft Teams is there. So we'll be using one of the tools to help us in video conferencing, and the synchronous teaching will happen there. To complement the synchronous teaching, we'll have some asynchronous teaching methods also. So when I say asynchronous, I'm trying to say that you will get some open educational resources, that is the books and the reading material, which will be available to you in the very beginning of the course on your LMS. Plus, some pre-recorded videos will also be available on the LMS, which will be on the critical topics which are very important from the placement perspective. In addition to this, There will be various discussion forums for the students, you know, where you can have a discussion with your peer group as well as your faculty members. Moving on next. Is the online teaching learning process. So as you know, I've briefed you that there will be various combination of synchronous and asynchronous teaching. So we'll have to use various tools and techniques as a combination for implementing the pedagogy. And we have to take care, special care of social distancing. And we want you to develop your peer group to have an interaction with your friends. So, you know, we can experiment with breakout rooms in Zoom where we can give you various activities to be done. And at the same time, since some of the material is available in asynchronous, so you have the advantage of learning at your own pace. So, you know, let's suppose there is a important topic of, you know, how to do Twitter data analytics or text analytics using various models that can be recorded, pre-recorded in the videos and available to you. And at your own speed, you can learn, you can view and review the videos. Plus, all the sessions which will be held online will also be available to you on your LMS post the classes to be viewed. So that's one of the advantage if you see, right? With this, I would like to thank you all for listening so patiently to me. And my email ID is mentioned on the slide itself. Plus, you can check my LinkedIn profile and approach me for any questions. If you're coming at IBS, they will be getting my details and my detailed profile available on the QuickForce also for your kind reference. So, all the best to all of you, and I wish to see you soon. Thank you.